Hey guys, and welcome back to what? Well, the World War II Solitaire board game channel and another unboxing video. Today we're gonna take a look at Bomb Run, and maybe you're thinking as you're watching this, Bomb Run? What is what? Bomb Run? Don't worry, because Bomb Run is unfortunately a game which is not very well known. But after you have watched this video, you're gonna know about Bomb Run, and a little bit in the future you're gonna also know how it's played. So, Bomb Run is a game which is designed by Chad Ruig. I don't know how to pronounce your name, Chad, but Chad's last name is spelled R-Y-G. In Sweden, we would say Ruig, but I'm guessing it's like Ruig, perhaps in the US. Anyway, it's designed by Chad, who was nice enough to send me this game, and it's published by Ruig Games, and you can get this game from thegamecrafter.com. You can find a link in the description of this video. This game is $34.99. So anyway, as you kind of can figure out here from the front of the box, this is a game about airplanes. And from the names, I guess you can also guess there is bombing planes. And that's just right. So before we open it up here, let's go ahead and take a look at the box. And let's take a look at the back of the box. Bomb Run, Farm Boys, City Slickers, a college prep, a roughneck. Whoever they are, there's 10 of them, and they have the same 25 missions in front of them. No table required, 5 to 20 minutes, 12 plus of age. And here we got, I don't know what these symbols mean. I guess these are symbols from the game, I would be guessing. Bomb Run is a deck-in-hand epic solo experience where your goal is to play out the 25 missions tour of a 10-man crew in a B-17G flying fortress over World War II Europe. All played out in your hands with a deck of cards guiding the narrative in your head. Each game is a mission that carries over from game to game. Your objective is to get as many of the crew to the end of their tour as you can. So, like that box said, this is a game about the B-17G Flying Fortress and the bombing campaign over Europe. You're going to have a 10-man crew, which you're going to get to follow throughout 25 missions to complete this game. So let's start by taking a look at these components. And once we have taken a look at all of it, we'll take a closer look. So here we have the very tiny, you see, compared to my hand, the very tiny rules booklet. And so I am pretty certain that this inlay that you see here is not part of the game if you buy it, because I was on thegamecrafter.com and it only says that it includes the box, the rules and the cards, but there is a link to where you can print this if you have a 3D printer. But if I'm incorrect, Chad will let us know in the comments, and I'm also going to update the description if that is the case, that this is actually included. But I am pretty sure that it's fairly confident that it's not included in the game. So anyway, we have what I'm guessing is mission cards, or maybe not. Let's see here, random event. Here we have the mission cards. And this should, I'm guessing this is our crew cards. Anyway, let's take a look, a closer look at all of the components. So the Bomb Run rules is, even though it's 39 pages, that is actually quite a lot. It's not so much because, like I said, it's a tiny rules booklet. You can also read the rules online if you prefer to do that. And they are available at thegamecrafter.com's page for Bomb Run. So Bomb Run is a 72 card deck with one bomber card, 11 double-sided mission cards, 6 zone cards, 24 Army Air Force cards, which represents the 10 crew cards, 10 replacement cards, replacement crew cards, 1 Little Friends card, 2 Wingman cards, and 1 Random Events card. Then we have 8 encounter cards, 12 damage cards, and 10 reference cards. So this game kind of reminds me of B-17 Queen of the Skies. I wonder if it's gonna be similar to that game. We see we have a lot of pictures, it's full color, some looks like some game examples. Here we have the game sequence. Each mission game follows a logical sequence in which the player will have to deal with challengers and encounters on the way to the bomb round and back to the base. So we have receive the mission, prepare the deck, take off, outbound leg, the bomb run, return leg, landing and recover. So that's pretty cool. We have the whole whole shebang. And the 25 really, excuse me, the 25 missions, that's if I understand correctly, it's what a tour of duty in Europe normally was. And there are some corrections in these rules. Chad told me that he did them himself, and that's going to be fixed for the latest version, which is now available on the Game Crafter. So those clarifications are already done to the rules. Something really cool about this game is that the crew cards are UV coated. So the crew cards can be written on. I'm guessing these are the crew cards. I'm not sure, but I think so. Radio operator. So anyway, they can be... you can mark them with a special pen and then remove that marker with... that's a replacement card, I guess. Remove that marker, you know, with a wipe and some alcohol. Anyway, let's go ahead and take a look at these cards. Here we have a radio operator. We see a lot of stuff going on this card. We have here radio room, no gun, replacement. And I don't know what this means. We have a T and a cross. Ability calls enemy positions to the formation. Find all wingmen and assign to enemy aircraft. Not available on flyby spotting. Make two thumbs up when attempting to repair own position. First aid as repair can recover S to L. And then we have all of these marks down here. So I'm not sure what this means, but of course we're going to find out. Position disabled on the back. And then we have the tail gunner. And all of them are going to be position disabled, I'm guessing, on the back. And we have the starboard gunner, the navigator, the flight engineer. It's really cool how these cards look like to be period photos, and then the character, the crew member, which you're looking at, he's colorized. That's pretty cool. Then we have the bombardier. The ball turret gunner, that's a guy that I wouldn't be jealous of. The co-pilot and the pilot. And like always, guys, if there's a special card which you're especially interested in, just go ahead and pause the video. There should be enough time for that. Whoops! Here we have another crew member, which is the port waste gunner. Again, really cool how they colorized the character. See a bunch of swastikas over here. I'm guessing perhaps that is to mark off your kills. So what do we have here? We have our mission cards, and those are going to be two-sided. So let's take a look at our mission card. Man, again, I gotta say the art is really cool, because here we see, of course, the terrain, the bombing target, I'm guessing, from the... spotters, the bombing spotters perspective. That's really cool. Again, a lot of information. It's going to be interesting to find out how this works. Mains, rail yard. And let's take them one side at a time. Castle, industry. Berlin, government. Pilsen, industry. Kiel, shipyard. Hanover, industry. Düsseldorf Industry, Rotterdam Industry, Le Havre Shipyard, Hamburg Shipyard, and Cologne Rail Yard. You see there's different numbers of swastikas here on these cards. They differ a little bit. I'm guessing these are, yeah, it's AA and stuff like that. Channel, mission. And then on the other side of those mission cards, we have Munich Ammo Depot, Schweinfurt Industry. Schweinfurt was a disaster, as you know. Schweinfurt Rail Yard, Bremen Shipyard, Dresden Military Objective, Stuttgart, another military, Leipzig Airfield. Oh, I'm not gonna try to pronounce that. Szczecin Military, Frankfurt Industry, Cologne Airfield, and finally we have Hamburg Military Target. And those are our mission cards. And here we have, I'm guessing this should be a random event card. It says there quite clearly. A random event card. Chaplain's Blessing, no more fighter encounters, only flak. Engine coughs and spurs to a stop. Search engine damage card and some symbol. 9 out of 10 cloud cover, no encounters this zone. And then we have another side. Here's a miracle. So some random events, and I'm guessing these are help cards and so on. Some of them are two-sided, not all of them. Let's take a look first of all at the ones that aren't two-sided. Action words. So here we can see some, it's gonna be a help card, I'm guessing. Takeoff and landing. Crew position. Mission sequence, and we already saw that in rules. Skills and luck. Through experience and surviving missions, crews gain skill and luck. That's pretty cool, man. And once they reach A status with 5 kills, they will do a double hit check for each one shot gun, or triple hit check or 2 shots gun. Don't know what that means, but it sounds awesome. Repairs. And encounter flags, so that's what those, yeah, the swastikas with the AA is for. So these are our helper cards. And these two-sided cards. Let's take a look. Fight fire. And fight fire, so it's a double-sided helper card. Engine landing gear fire. And then we have rescue. And bail out. So a lot of helper cards. Encounter fighter, and that is a two-sided helper card. There is a lot of helper cards, a lot of stuff which you can do. Just here looking, bailing out and stuff like that. And rescue. After bailout or ditching at sea, determine rescue chance from the mission card. So you can see here, conduct 3 success checks for each survivor to determine if rescued. High, low, not likely. So anyway, that's our helper cards and our random event. And ooh, we have a lot of cards here. See, these seem to be different. And here's actually a pilot, a crew card. So here we have Port Waste Gunner, Harold Tyler. And I'm gonna have to sort this up. I see we have more of these guys here. Give me a moment. All right, there we go. We got our cards sorted up. So these are gonna be, I'm guessing, our original crew. And these are, I'm guessing, these are replacements, since all of them say replacement. And these guys actually have names. So then we have the flight engineer, which is Mike Bailey. If I can get my camera to focus a little bit better. And we have the starboard waste gunner, Hank Perkins, the bombardier, Vincent Duran, radio operator, Don Richardson. The pilot, whose name is Jimmy Hansen. The navigator, which is Tom Lemansky. The ball turret gunner, which is Dale Holland. The co-pilot, which is Bill Sherman. The tail gunner, which is Leo Dole. And then we have a bunch of encounter cards. And again, we have some great graphics here. This is going to be Flak. We have a... I'm not going to pronounce that because it usually doesn't end well. A Messerschmitt. Another Messerschmitt, 1/10. Another 1/9. Flak. One of those wolves. Messerschmitt, 1/9. And then we have Engine. Conduct a damage check. And we have a few of these cards. And all of these cards are one-sided. And then we have Control card. Conduct a damage check. And then we have a Wingman card. Actually, we have a few. Two of those. Structure. Also, check for damage. And Landing Gear. Check for damage. And finally, we have here Little Friends. Engage all enemy aircraft on initial attack and engage individual aircraft and on successive attacks. And then we have a few more cards here. Not sure what this is. I'm guessing perhaps this is for your bomber, your plane card. So I'm guessing maybe you're going to put your bomber's name here. And again, you're UV coated, so you can get rid of that stuff later. And then we have... I'm not sure what this is. Some maps. England. The English Channel. Zone 1. These are one side as well. Zone 2. Zone 3. And Zone 4. I'm guessing these are just going to be cards to remind you where you're at or where you're going. Something like that. And anyway, my friends, that should be all of it. Let's see that we didn't miss anything. And again, this inlay, I think you have to print it yourself with a 3D printer. So anyway, this is it, guys. This is it. This is Bomb Run. This can also be played cooperatively. 2 to 3 players, but each player has to have their own deck. So if that's something you enjoy, I think that is actually a cool idea, because most solo games can be played cooperatively relatively easily. And I like co-op just as much as I like solo. I just don't have too many friends who like World War II cooperative games. That's the problem. Of course, we're going to be playing this game in the future, so stay tuned to the channel. I have to learn how to play the game. I have to play a few sessions. Like I said, it's 25 missions, and each mission is 5 to 20 minutes depending on the mission. So a whole campaign can be quite long, actually. But of course, we're gonna try to do a whole campaign. That's the fun, you know, that's the fun way of doing it. So again, thank you very much for watching. You can get this from the Game Crafter, link in the description. Thank you, Chad, for sending me the game. And also now is going to come a small channel update following the latest channel update on the whole situation with everything going on in my life. So if you're not interested particularly in that, just go ahead and close this video, because everything about Bomb Run is over. Now comes some of my babbling. Okay, guys, here I come. Hey guys, before I let you go, I just wanted to give you a little bit of an update on my current situation. Kind of a follow-up on my previous video, which was a channel update where I was talking about how I have to move to a different country and all of this to get treatment for my deadly disease, which is called cystic fibrosis. So first of all, I just want to go ahead and say thank you so much to everyone for showing you support. I have gotten hundreds of comments, messages, and so on. And you might not think that it means that it does, you might think that it doesn't mean anything, but it does. Every single comment means so much. And I was really genuinely overwhelmed by all of the support. And this is one of the reasons why I love solitaire gaming, because it's anything else but solitaire. There is such a great, huge community out there. And I mean, I've seen other people have a hard time in life, and everyone has always been so fast, you know, to offer support and so on. So I think we have a great community. And again, it's solitaire gaming, but it certainly isn't something you do by yourself or alone. I feel way more alone if I'm playing a PC game, something like that, or if I'm playing a game like this, because if I'm playing a solo game, I always got you guys in mind. And you know, sometimes I play solitaire by myself without recording, and something happens and I'm like, oh man, I wish I was recording, because I kind of want to share that situation with you guys. Anyway, I'm gonna try to keep this short. So thank you anyway, all of you. A big special thank you to Dennis from Danvers and Games. I mean, Danvers and Games, you're just awesome. I got a message from Dennis like, hey man, you want any game to keep you company, you know, in these hard times? Dude, I'm all good. I got Warfighter. I mean, Warfighter is my go-to game, and if I ever have to lock myself into a bunker, it's gonna be with Warfighter. And just quickly to update you about the situation, so the channel, I'm sorry, my lungs. The channel is, you know, not super right now prioritized, as I will move to Denmark in the end of May. So I have about 2 months now. I have to get rid of all my furniture. I'm not selling a single World War II board game. I promise you guys, I'm keeping them all. But I am selling most of my other stuff, like Pandemics, which you can see here. I got a bunch of other stuff here, Lord of the Rings, World of Warcraft, and whatnot. I got basically a few hundreds of board games, and I'm keeping the World War II stuff, because that's what I'm mainly playing. So anyway, I had to get you know, rid of all my furniture. I sold my snowmobile, snow scooter, I guess it's called in English. I did sell my one of my guns, my submachine gun, but I got a revolver and still two pistols to sell, Colt 1911 and a Walther pistol. So I got a lot of stuff to deal with. I'm also, you know, everything I'm packing, I'm throwing away stuff, I'm putting stuff out for sale on Facebook and so on. So and I have to work extra days as well to get, you know, save as much money as I can, because the rent in Copenhagen, where I'm going, here I pay $500, and that includes internet, electricity, water, and in Copenhagen, I'm going to pay for a small one-room apartment, I'm going to pay $2,000 a month, and that is not including electricity and internet, and the move-in fee is $10,000. So basically, I'm spending my life savings going to Copenhagen. But it doesn't matter, because it's just money, and I want to survive. Anyway, this is getting long now. We're running up to 5 minutes, and I don't want to this segment to take over my unboxing of Bombrum. I'm gonna sit down now. I pre-read the rules online, but I kind of want to read the rules with all of the stuff laid out, you know, in front of me, because that is the best way to learn, in my opinion, to have the game in front of you so that you can, you know, check the different parts as you're reading about them. So stay tuned to the channel, because there is a playthrough of Bombrun coming. I'm also hoping to do a playthrough of Warfighter World War II with the Talvisota, Jaktosorta, and all the Sortas. All the wars from Finland in World War II, which would be the Finnish Winter War, the Continuation War, and the Lapland War. Okay, guys, that's it from me. I'm going to go ahead and let you go now. And as always, guys, thank you very much for watching. See you next time.